Okay, this is my new system for making kefir cream cheese. And these jars were on the counter for 24 hours with the kefir grains in them, you know, in the milk. And then when it started to kind of, you could see, well, I don't know if you can't really see the separation because I've been jiggling it around. You can't really see the separation on here, but you'll sometimes see a little bit of separation, just a slight separation of curds and whey, meaning the whey protein and the creamy part. And plus when you jiggle it, it's thicker and so on. So that's 24 hours on the counter. You'll see that it's ready. And you take the grains out, put them in new milk, and you're left with this smoothie type mixture, like a kefir smoothie. And you can just flavor it and drink it if you want, but I don't. I take that smoothie and I strain it in the refrigerator so that the whey protein falls to the bottom and the curds are up at the top, because I want the creamy curds at the top for my cream cheese. So I'm kind of, you know, in the middle of everything of this cycle, because it is a cycle and it just keeps repeating itself. So these went 24 hours. We're going to take the grains out. Now, a lot of times if it's ready, if it's 24 hours and the grains are ready to be taken out and put in new milk, sometimes I don't have time, or I just didn't finish my other kefir cream, which I'll show you that in a minute over here. I didn't even finish the ones that I made a couple days ago, the cream cheese. So then if I'm not ready to make these into the cream cheese, I just take them off the counter and stick them in the fridge just like they are, with the grains in them. They're all done, and they'll slow down. The grains will slow down. They'll kind of like go dormant until I'm ready. It's usually just a day or two that I put them in there, but you can leave them in there up to a week. They really get dormant though if you leave them that long. So anyways, that's what happened with these. I wasn't ready for them, so they were in the fridge. So the kefir that you see is going to be a little thicker than it usually is. So the first thing I do is I take off the paper coffee filter and I just pour this into this strainer. This is the one, you can get it from Amazon, and the holes are really small. And it's nylon, because you don't want any metal to touch your kefir grains. And you'll see it looks real runny at the top, but that's because the whey protein kind of already separated. So, and now you'll see it just clump out, okay? It normally shouldn't look like that, but I let it sit for a long time in the fridge. And this rubber spatula is only used for kefir. And so is this, and so is this bowl. And so are these jars, by the way. So, and you'll notice now, so I just kind of push it around. And honestly, it doesn't usually look this runny, but I think I've been leaving it in the fridge too long lately, and my grains aren't, I don't know, they're kind of mad at me. But anyways, so, and you'll notice from my other video, I was only using maybe this much grains for 2 cups of milk. Now I'm using all these grains for like 1.5 cups of milk. And it doesn't even matter. I mean, they'll eat whatever you put, you know, however much you put. Sometimes if you, the more grains you have, the more lactose it's going to eat. So then, you know, it'll be, for somebody who's lactose intolerant, it'll be easier on your stomach. So that's about, gosh, more than 2 heaping tablespoons. So you just kind of mush it around, and this, if I were to mix this, all the thickness of it, the thick and the thin parts, so now you'll see the creaminess of the kefir smoothie. I usually don't mix it because I strain it anyways to get the whey protein to separate. So, and then also, I'll just put this on here for a moment. Got to get the rest of it out of here. Whoops. See, I'm out of my comfort zone. I got to get the rest of it out of the bottom here. Okay. But it just tastes like a tangy, and when I rinse this, I rinse it in hot water, the jar, and then you can't see this. I do squirt a little bit of soap in it, even though on my previous videos I said don't use soap. I use it now. I just feel better. And let's see if I can. And I just make it all come out. And I keep it upside down for a few minutes, a minute or so, and get my milk out. And this is the Hartzler's dairy milk that I get from Bueller's. It comes from grass-fed cows. It is 2%. You can use whole. If you're going to get just organic milk from like Giant Eagle, I would start with whole milk because maybe there'll be more in it for the kefir grains to eat. And so I usually put, like I said, oh, and I got to run my hot water because I fill up a glass jar halfway with hot water to warm up the milk. Because it seems to like it at room temperature or warmer. The grains work really fast when you have, that's only 1.5 cups. That's only because I don't eat that much. I could put 2 cups in, but anyways, the warmer your room or the warmer the milk, the faster it makes kefir. So, okay. And so, and since it was in the fridge, they're not even gonna be too terribly shocked. And you want them to be kind of stringy. Normally, I don't know if you can see any, let's see. When my grains are really plump and active, when you go like this, you'll see strings coming from them. But they're not real happy because I've been putting them in the fridge a lot. So they're not even as plump as they normally are, but they are still really good grains. But, so you just take it and put it in your mouth. Okay, so I put that aside, and so here's my smoothie. Now I'm going to make cream cheese out of this smoothie, and but the problem, and so I don't use my big ball jars anymore, like in my other video. What I use now, let me move this out of the way, is I found these little, they're microwave things, you know, they have a little vent. Actually, I should have that vent closed. And this is how I strain my kefir now. I have the plastic coffee filter that you can buy that's reusable, and then the paper one here, and the brown paper one. And it just hangs on there so nicely, and that's all I do, and I leave it in there, and you can see how firm the cream cheese is. And this has probably been 2 days though, but still, 1 day in the fridge draining like this is enough. I guess you could actually make hard cheese out of it if you keep, you could take this out and, you know, tie it up and dry it out for even longer. You could flavor it just like you would make cheese, but I'm not going to do that. So, but I haven't used this cream cheese, so I have to put it in something. And I like to put them in plastic when they're touching it, but, well, here, I'll just put them in this. So I'm going to take this out, and I'll just make something out of this dip or ice cream later. But then you can see all the whey protein in there. And that's good for people who lift weights. You know, this is the real deal, whey protein. And it's a probiotic whey protein as well. Oh, and I think somebody wanted this, so let's see. Going to make a cardinal sin and put this in a plastic jar for my friend. Okay, so, and then I just take this and rinse it with hot water. And I rinse everything. I rinse this. And I rinse this. I don't use soap in here because you don't even need to use soap anywhere. Some people don't even rinse their kefir jars. They just keep it going. Nothing bad can grow in kefir in the vicinity. So, okay. So now it's ready to take some new, a new kefir smoothie. And we have a whole lot of room here. Okay. So we're just going to pour this in here. And it just looks like a smoothie, like I said. You can flavor it with honey and blueberries and flax seeds and anything you want. Anything you make cream cheese out of, you can make, or even cottage cheese, you can use your kefir. So there it is, and now it's ready to go in the fridge. So you can't really leave it out anymore. Yeah, there's microscopic kefir baby grains in there. It probably would be fine, but you know, the big grains are gone. They're in the new milk. So now you want to put it in the fridge. So put this in the fridge, and tomorrow it'll be strained good enough. It'll be strained good enough tomorrow. And so then The other one that was in the water is done. It's fine. And you could see the grains floating on top. And I reuse these with the rubber band. And that's it. And then this I do not leave out on my counters anymore. Now kefir, unlike other type of fermentation like canning and that, kefir likes to have oxygen when it's fermenting. And I'm probably doing a disservice to my kefir by putting it in this pan. I'll show you where I put it. If I can get the camera over there. Whoops. Okay. So this is just a pot and, you know, with the lid. And I put it in there. And then I put the lid on it. And it probably gets air even with the lid on it, you know. But then I also clip it. Like that. And so it'll sit like this then for 24 hours. But I have to do the other jar. I have to put the other jar in. And so that's it. And then after 24 hours, we start all over again. I pull the grains out like I did at the beginning of the video. And, rinse the jar and so on and so on. And put the grains in new milk and strain the smoothie into the plastic container and so on. So there you have it.